you have a crisis management plan and you're eliminating the redundancy or any natural disaster that happens, and how do you, you know, just eliminate those disasters? Thank you.
Okay, I take not the first question, of course, and I leave it to the experts. Okay, see, when you talk about the security staff, being paid less, and they need to be a part of the overall cyber physical security journey, okay, we are supposed to be their social part of it. Now, just to give you a small example, biggest company, large size companies, basically the physical security is, again, it will revolve around the, like I said, the access control systems and the electronic surveillance, when you say, can CCTVs. Now, in HCL Tech, in HCL Tech itself, we have around 250 CCTV and access control servers, and that includes the closet also. So 250 of them, and 250 are access control data itself. It's around 2 terabytes, and if I add to it the archived data, it will go up to something like 7-8 TVs. Now CCTV alone, but we have to process, the HCL Tech has to process 150 TB of data. So this certainly is not possible. You see, sometimes, like, I started off my physical security journey way back in 2007, and I've seen that the, I mean, a lot of, distance has been covered by way of the cloud computing. So I agree with, Rahul and Kas also. When they say that it has nothing to do with the cost of cutting, it has got everything to do with the cloud computing speeds. The amount of comfort that I get today handling all this data that I mentioned, CCTVs, access controls data, the amount of comfort that I get when I know it, the encryption is there, okay, which may have been there or would have been hacked into easily. So the encryption is there. Second thing, I am aware that the scalability is there. I mean, you tell me today, okay, some new site to be started off in Hyderabad, it would have given me nightmares, a couple of years back. But today I know it, that we can simply scale up, add on some licenses, and then just carry on. So that way, I mean, there's nothing that, and by the way, the security companies, I don't know if some of our security agency partners are also here or not. See, they are the ones who are really spending big time into the training of these guys to support the whole journey which is going around. So, I work with 7-8 security vendors right now. And of them, I've seen it. The way our CCTV operator, the way our access control guys, the way they help out in the MIS, the data churning, the data compiling, is excellent.
May I add, I think that answers your first question.
Can I just add? Well, I think you had 3 questions. First was, how do you choose the cloud service provider? Second was, how do you ensure that people who are lowly paid do not become the, and I think third was, what was the third question?
How do you manage the redundancy
So I think when it comes to selection, I think there are standards available. So I think one of the elementary is that whether the service provider is ISO 27001 compliant, you can look at SOC S2 from an audit perspective, whether that compliance is there. There are also industry-specific compliances. So, you know, let's say if somebody is going to, so if you're serving the US organization, then you need a compliance which is called FISMA, which is federal, industry security, information security. So those compliances are there. So I think those are the basic qualifiers for you to basically look at those, you know, short selection and then selecting order, and then of course cost always remains one of the criteria when you want to make a choice after you've looked at all these compliances. Second, coming to the manpower, I think, which I think Colonel Saab definitely spoke, I think there is the access control which helps you, you know, kind of control the access of who gets in and who doesn't get in. There is, of course, screening, background screening that are done to ensure that the access is not available. I think now with the advent of AI, it has become much, much better, because now you can also look at the behavioral patterns of a human being. You know, because a person who was hired, let's say a year back, and was screened well, over the period of time, how has he got changed with his, you know, data being taken from his social media and all that, which can be scanned to see if there are certain changes which are happening in his behavior patterns to ensure that you do not have some kind of sabotage being planned. So there are, I think technology is helping there, and I'm sure Kunal can add to, I'm just speaking some bits there. And third is from a point of how do you ensure redundancy. I think redundancy, DRCs are very prevalent concepts. I think most of the other organizations ensure that they don't put a data center near a front line, near a fault line. So they ensure that it is in a location which is not impacted with it. Cloud, of course, offers the flexibility that you have a DRC to fall back globally at a different location itself geographically. Redundancies in terms of mirroring of data does happen. So I think those are, I hope I have answered, I don't know whether I answered what you asked for, but I think these are certain things which are already existing, and I think with the technology becoming much smarter, especially on the physical security, I think the controls and governance is becoming much better. Yeah.
Thank you.
I think great discussion points. I think we've pretty much covered all of the aspects and the entire spectrum of cloud security. Thank you for being such a brilliant set of panelists. Big round of applause for the panelists.
Well, thank you so much, sirs, for this very productive, enlightening session. And I think all the question has been answered very beautifully and confidently. I would like to request you to kindly remain seated on stage. Now I would like to call upon stage Dr. P.C. Wadhwa, sir, to felicitate our expert panelists. Everyone, please give a round of applause. We'll start the felicitation with Mr. Nitin Sharma. Sir, please come forward. Everybody, just give a huge round of applause to Mr. Nitin. He's been an amazing speaker throughout the session.
Thank you.
It's time to felicitate Mr. Sandeep Moza. Sir, please come forward. Thank you so much for being an amazing pathfinder for all of us. Thank you so much. Now, I would like to request Mr. Vikas Saxena, sir, to please come forward. Everyone, we will also want to know the secret of this healthy lifestyle backstage. Alright. Colonel Devendra Kasan, sir, please come forward. And it's a proud moment to have an army, former army officer. But army officer has always been an army officer. Soldier has always been a soldier. He's always considered as a soldier. So thank you so much, sir. And now it's time to felicitate, last but not the least, our moderator, Mr. Kunal Govil, sir. Thank you so much for beautifully moderating this panel discussion. We've learned a lot. And we are looking forward for more sessions like this in your moderation. Thank you so much. Let's have a group photograph together. All, please come forward. Thank you. It's time for our goal partner presentation. First of all, we are very thankful to our goal partner to your valuable contribution in this event. I would like to request representative from Agilent Cables to come forward for your presentation.